Cars impounded by police for hooning are being released by magistrates who accept sob stories from the hoons. The Herald Sun says at least 828 Victorian offenders with so-called hardship stories have had their cars released by the court since laws took effect a decade ago. It says repeat offenders who've previously had their licences suspended or disqualified are the most successful. This is a hot topic this morning. To discuss it, we're joined by Darren Hinch and Pauline Hanson. Morning to you both. Darren, what's going on here? Why are the magistrates giving these cars back to the hoons just because of a sob story? Oh, I can't get from A to B. Well, you should have thought about that before you hooned.
It is a joke. I mean, one guy, he was worried about getting his car back. He was caught doing 200 kilometres per hour in a police pursuit. He shouldn't have been worried about getting his car back. He should have been worrying about how many months he was going to spend in jail.
Mm. Exactly. Pauline, do the courts need to be tougher with hoons? And, you know, they brought down these tough laws to seize the cars. Now they're giving them back to them.
Definitely, definitely, Sam. What a joke the whole thing is. That's why there's no respect for authority. We have repeat offenders, and I travel the country quite extensively listening to people. This is one of the issues about the sentencing and the judges. People are fed up with it. We've got to get tough. The police are fed up with it as well. They get the criminals, and in this case, the hoons, they take them in, the judges then release them with no fines and giving them back their cars. I understand the police have only handed back 10. So when you look at the comparison of 828 compared to 10 by the police, what I'd like to see, the judges are not answerable to anyone. I'd like to see a panel put in place that the public themselves can complain to to the panel in regards to a judge if he hasn't handed out a tough enough sentence. The judge then goes before the panel and he has to say why he shouldn't lose his job. Let the Australians decide, do they want these judges or not? And if they're not doing their job in line with what the Australian people want, then get rid of them. Get people who will.
One of the points here, Pauline and Sam, is that they made a big deal about how their police powers had been increased. They could then impound them for 30 days rather than 48 hours, as it was originally brought into place. But it didn't work. In 2012, they released nearly one a day. I mean, you're quite right. If laws are not enforced, they're not worth having. If, for example, you've got in many states, 25 years now for rape, and yet the average in most states is about 4.5, 5 years. So if the laws are in place, they should be enforced.
Okay, look, let's talk about Easter. It is Easter week after all. Christian leaders around the world are continuing discussions for a fixed date for Easter, and of course this year it is very early. Former Deputy Prime Minister Tim Fischer says Australia should lead the way. He wants state and territory leaders to mandate Good Friday on the first Friday in April. He says it would provide stability of planning and boost productivity. Pauline, what do you make of this?
No, I totally disagree. This is a world celebration with Easter, and I just don't believe that we should be out there leading the way whatsoever. This is in line with the Vatican, with the Pope and the Catholic religion. I don't agree with it. Listen, what's the big rush? What's the big hurry? We only just got a four-year set term in Queensland for the politicians to set a date. We're still waiting for the federal government. So what's the big issue? It's once a year? No.
But
leave it until we're in line with the rest of the world.
Hang on, look. The thing here, people tend to forget, this was a pagan festival to start with. It's all about the equinox and the moon. It's nothing to do with Christianity at all. And the fact that they've been bitching about it to each other for 1,000 years and now say they may come to an agreement between 5 or 10 years, frankly, I don't care when they have Easter, but the one thing I don't agree with Tim Fischer on is he also said at the same time Australia Day should be moved to a set, to different days should rotate. Either, if we're going to move Australia Day at all, it should go to January 1, which is Commonwealth Day, about Federation, and that would take away all the controversy about Invasion Day.
Mm. See, I think it's really confusing. Most Australians don't really know what, you know, the religious symbolism. They just want the days off. So why not put it somewhere where we know where it is, where we can sort of plan our holidays? I guess that's what it's all about these days. Thank you to both of you. Okay. Have a good day.
All right, thanks, Sam.
All right, here's Koshy.